Good morning, students of class 8B. In this video class of geometry, you are welcome. In the last video, I had uploaded proof 1. And in this video now, we will see proof 2 and proof 3. The statement of proof 2 is, if a pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral are equal and parallel, it is a parallelogram. A pair of opposite sides. For that, I have considered one parallelogram ABCD in which a pair of opposite sides I have used AB and CD. Regarding these two sides, it is given that these are equal and parallel. So, in given information, I have written AB equal to CD and AB parallel to CD. And then we are asked to prove that it is a parallelogram. If these two are equal and these two are parallel, and secondly, if we prove BC is also parallel to AD, then ABCD will be the parallelogram. So, our aim is to prove BC is parallel to AB. For that, I went in these two triangles, in triangle ABD and triangle BCD, to prove that these two triangles are congruent. For that, I need three conditions. First condition is angle ABD equal to angle CDB, because if these two are parallel, then these two angles will be equal, being the alternate angles. So I wrote angle ABD equal to angle CDB, alternate angles. Secondly, I wrote AB is equal to CD, because opposite sides are equal, it is given in the statement only, equal. And third condition, I found that BD is common side for both the triangles. So I wrote BD is common. So from these three conditions, we can say triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BCD from the axiom of SAS, side angle side. And then I used CPCT, corresponding part of congruent triangle. Because if two triangles are congruent, then the remaining corresponding parts of the triangles will also be equal. So from CPCT, I wrote angle ADB, this angle, angle ADB equal to angle CBD. These two angles became equal, I wrote here from CPCT. And if these two angles became equal, then we can say AD is parallel to BC, because these two became the alternate angles. So I wrote here AD is parallel to BC. So what did you see? AB is parallel to CD, it is given in the statement, and I proved that AD is parallel to BC, therefore ABCD is a parallelogram. Third proof is, the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. ABCD is a parallelogram. In this AC and BD, these two are the diagonals. We are asked to prove diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other, means OA equal to OC and OB equal to OD. For that, I went in triangle OAB and COD. OAB and COD, or OCD you can say. Our aim is to prove these two triangles are congruent. For that, we need three conditions to prove these two triangles are congruent. The first condition is angle BAO equal to angle DCO. Angle BAO equal to angle DCO, because these two became the alternate angles. Opposite sides of parallelogram are parallel, therefore these two will be the alternate angles, those two will be equal. Second condition, AB equal to CD. These two are the opposite sides of a parallelogram. So opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. So I wrote here AB equal to CD, opposite sides of a parallelogram. Third condition, angle ABO, this one, equal to angle CDO, this one. These two will also be equal because these two are also alternate angles. On the basis of these three conditions, we can say triangle OAB is congruent to triangle COD from ASA axiom of congruency. Applying CPCT, we can say OA equal to OC and OB equal to OD from CPCT. Hence, diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other, proved. In question number 1, exercise 14.2, in question number 1, the question is, two sides of a parallelogram are in the ratio 3:4. If its perimeter is 42 cm, find the lengths of its sides. I have drawn a figure of parallelogram ABCD in which BC is to AB is given in the question 3:4. So for that I consider let the breadth and the length. Actually, we should write here name of the side, not the breadth and length. Let BC and AB. Let BC and AB of the parallelogram be 3x and 4x respectively. The perimeter is given in the question. The perimeter equal to 42 cm, and you know the perimeter of any figure is the sum of all the sides. So at the place of this perimeter I wrote AB plus BC plus CD plus AD. This became the sum of all the sides, that is equal to 42 cm. AB is 4x, BC is 3x, CD is equal to AB because opposite sides of parallelogram are equal, so this also became 4x, plus AD is opposite side of BC, while BC is 3x, so AD will also be 3x. At the place of AD I wrote here 3x. In this way I got the expression 4x plus 3x plus 4x plus 3x equal to 42 cm. I have added all this, I got 14x equal to 42 cm. So x equal to 42 by 14, that is 3 cm. Now the sides of the parallelogram AB, that is 4x. So 4 into 3, this at the place of x I kept this 3 cm. Multiplied I got 12 cm. BC is 3x. So 3 into 3 cm, 9 cm. CD is 4x because these two are opposite sides, both will be equal. If this is 4x, this CD will also be 4x. Equal to 4 into 3 cm, that is equal to 12 cm. And AD is equal to BC, both are opposite sides of the parallelogram. If BC is 3x, then AD will also be 3x. So AD equal to 3x equal to 3 into 3 cm, that is equal to 9 cm. So the sides of the parallelogram became 12 cm, 9 cm, 12 cm and 9 cm. In question number 3, the sum of adjacent angles 180 degree and these two adjacent angles are given 4x minus 15 degree and 5x minus 3 degree. So angle C plus angle D equal to 180 degree because angle C and angle D, these two are adjacent angles. We can say angle A and angle B is also adjacent angles. Similarly, angle B and angle C is adjacent angles. Angle C and angle D are adjacent angles, and angle D and angle A are adjacent angles. So angle C plus angle D equal to 180 degree. This is the sum of adjacent angles, that is equal to 180 degree. I have kept the values. Angle C I have considered 4x minus 15 degree plus angle D 5x minus 3 degree equal to 180 degree. 4x plus 5x, 9x minus 15 minus 3, 18 degree, that is equal to 180 degree. So 9x equal to 180 degree plus 18 degree, this became 9x equal to 198 degree. So x equal to 198 degree by 9, that is equal to 22 degree. I divided 198 by 9, I got 22 degree. Now angle C equal to 4x minus 15 degree. Equal to 4 into 22. At the place of x, I kept this value of x 22. 4 into 22 degree minus 15 degree. that is equal to 88 minus 15 degree, that is equal to 73 degree. Opposite angles are equal, so angle C equal to angle A. If angle C is 73 degree, then angle A will also be 73 degree. Now angle D, that is 5x minus 3 degree, that is equal to 5 into 22. At the place of caps, at the place of x, I kept the value of x, that is 22 degree. 5 into 22 minus 3, that became 110 minus 3, that is equal to 107 degree. Now angle D is equal to angle B, because these two are the opposite angles of a parallelogram. If angle B is 107 degree, then angle B will also be 107 degree. These are the angles of the parallelogram.